Hey everybody, welcome to the channel. I am Pete. This is it playable on the Steam Deck? And we're gonna check out one of my favorite games of all time, Kingdoms of Amalur: Reckoning. I forgot that I had this in my Steam library. I played it primarily on Xbox 360, PlayStation 3 back in the day. And so I thought, you know, I was looking through my library and I'm like, man, I'd like to try this on my Steam Deck. I'm like, I'll definitely roll a different class and try it again. So let's get into it. So this is the Steam Deck compatibility, so it is not verified. We all know unverified games run at different levels of acceptance. So we're gonna get in and try it. For some reason, I must have tried this on my computer a while ago, so I just updated today. So I didn't play it today, so basically I just downloaded it on my Steam Deck. We're gonna go in and let's take a look at, before we go in, there's an official controller setup already default. Let's get into it. So if you don't know about Kingdoms of Amalur, this is the whole Kurt Schilling debacle, 3-8 Studios, Island of Rhode Island. This was a game that Kurt Schilling's studio bought the studio that made this. So he didn't really develop this. They just kind of finished it and published it. They were working on a different game, an MMO that never saw the light of day. But unfortunately, there's a whole series of events that happened here. But anyway, what we're going to do is we're going to put up the performance things. I gotta do that. Oops, I should have done that right away. I always forget to put this up, and people always tell me in the comments, make sure to put it up, because it's very helpful to people. They want to know how it runs, right? So anyway, yeah, so there's this whole story around what had happened and things like that, so go check that out. But anyway, I'm playable. It's playable. What we're doing is checking out if it works out of the box, or is there a proper control scheme that we can play it here. So I don't know if it just crashed right away, or I don't know what happened here. There we go. Loaded in. And yeah, so 3-8 Studios. Of course, 3-8 was Big Huge Games. It was the ones that developed it. So 3-8 Studios is Kurt Schilling. 3-8 was his number in the major leagues. He was a major league pitcher. So we're going to get in. We're going to have some fun with this, shall we? All right, let's see. It should kind of, this is the first thing. I don't want to do that. Account management. I don't want to do that. What? So this is not working right away. So I'm going to go into my Steam controllers and go into my controller settings and is there a community layout? Yeah, there's community. Let's do this. Okay, so it wants an email address. All right, let me try to log in here. Oh boy. Okay, the account setup of this is really weird. So I'm gonna try it again, and we're gonna do a new game. I'm gonna do normal, and we're just gonna log in. It kind of kept freezing at the thing. So everything works. The buttons are working, which is really cool. I already know the story of this game, so I don't really need to watch the cinematics. But this is the start. So if you're not familiar with the game, you start up as a
what do you think this one is then?
Yeah, a dead person.
Could even be a Jotun. Always a surprise.
But this game really came out, and it came out during the same time as Skyrim. And Skyrim took the world by storm, and this one kind of got lost in the shuffle, which is kind of unfortunate because I played a ton of this. I played all of the expansions. All right, so I got to remember where to go here. So I'm going to do, so this is your, you can do female or male. You can check, find your race here. Proud and ancients. I usually took humans, and I think I took Verani usually to my first playthrough of this game. So I'll try something different here. I'll take Dokathar, renowned as sophisticated students of magic and diplomacy, where they do not shy away from conflict for to resolve disputes. That doesn't sound like me. Okay, I'm gonna do that anyway. It doesn't sound like me. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna go magic user, goddess of wisdom, love, death. So this is basically the bonus points you get. Since I'm gonna go wizard, I'm gonna go fate, because I want mana regen. So you got some presets here. That looks kind of cool, right? That looks pretty cool. I like that. This guy's got... Oh, this guy's cool. I'll take this guy. I don't know. This guy, like, kind of cool, too. He's kind of bald and stuff. I'm going to go with him. So he can adjust his face. Make him kind of a little bit more skin tone. You can darken him up. You can light him up. You can kind of make him really pale. I'm going to go put in the middle. Eye color. Stubble. Stubble intensity. Gonna give him 5 o'clock shadow. Why not? Cool. All right. And then you can do his hairstyle. So you can give him hair if I want. I don't want to keep him bald. I don't know. I might want to give him a mohawk if I can. Yeah. Yes, I can. Gonna give him gray. There you go. Facial hair. I don't know. I like that. Mix and match. Now I'll do go like that. And I want to do is stubble. I'm going to give him really bad 5 o'clock shadow. Okay. And then you can go in jewelry. You can add jewelry if you want to. Give him a nose ring. Now I like his tattoos. And there we go. And you confirm it. And that's it. That is me. So basically you get reborn in this game. I know, a very familiar trope, right?
Make sure it goes into the report.
He's all about the reports. It's pretty funny. How well the body held up. This game is so awesome.
I'm just glad it's not moving.
Well, I'm dead. I'm not going to be moving.
Lucky star, this one. Anything else we need?
Likely star, probably. Unless you'd like to name him. I definitely want to be a mage, so I'm going to try mage, because I always tried, before I used to be a kind of a soldier warrior. Enter name. Yeah, let's do Carwin. Yeah, why not, right? That seems okay. Go do that. I like sometimes just doing whatever they give me as a name, just for fun.
Well, that's it for you then. Better luck next time.
Here I go. Just throw me in a giant furnace. I could probably look at the display on this. Okay, time to wake up, buddy. Oh, I'm there with a bunch around. Imagine waking up being Hey, wait, did they dump somebody on top of me? How long have they been down there? It's like, there must have been a passage of time. Definitely must have been a passage of time. There we go. Gross. Squishy wishy. But there's so much content in this game. And I believe a studio bought the rights a little while ago and it's creating an actual proper expansion to this too. So new DLC came out for this, which is remarkable. I haven't checked yet. I haven't played the new expansion to this. I only played the original expansions for it. The original DLC. Here I am. All right. Back in the day, alright, cool. Let me see if I can do something with the options for display, gameplay, audio, resolution. That's all I get. Graphics, can I set the... Oh no, I can't set the high post-processing enabled. Standard. All right, so I can't set the resolution, unfortunately. No widescreen option. All right, so I do remember that the stick being kind of unwieldy in the original, and I always had to go in and adjust that. Controls. Difficulty normal, auto saves on. And then I'm going to go to controls and camera sensitivity. I'm gonna turn it way down. Make sure that's saved. Did I go over past it? Yeah, a little bit better, but still, it kind of gets unwieldy, the controls on this. Oh, there's something glowing over here. Man, this is like nostalgia. We should have used the little notes. Yeah, I haven't... Alright, take the rusty sword. You have a new thing. Inventory weapons. Primary. There we go. Got a rusty sword.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Scatter, children of dust.
Man, that's crazy. So this is the tutorial section? But yeah, it runs great. Just gotta figure out where I'm going. Yeah, let's go this way. There's my sword. And the first enemy. Giant rat, of course. And I got 9 XP. So it's got a lot of influences from, like, classic games of that era. Did this guy drop anything? Cool, nope. Let's keep going. That's my dive at it away. Oh, got some gold there. Sweet. It's really dark in here.
Anybody?
Anybody? We'll help you. We'll go get you, buddy.
Yo, up there, please help me. Please.
Oh, little scum. There we go, some bad guys. I mean, the combat, I really always loved the combat in this game. It's pretty cool. Cool. And it gets a little bit more complex as you go. You're welcome, sir. You were dead. Yes, I was. Yes, I am alive. Okay, so this is the, I'm not dead.
No, clearly not.
So you get your decision wheel. Again, a game that was created 10 years ago, right? A little bit more than that, probably. I can't remember when this came out, actually. It's been so long. But there's a lot of story in here, and, like, tons of bits of open world, too. Not as immense as Skyrim's open world, but, like, there are open worlds, a lot of quests, and... side quests and stuff like that.
Professor Former assumes the Well of Souls is his life's work. The Tuatha are coming into the lower levels.
Tuatha.
We should be able to beat them to the top. Take these. They'll help keep you safe long enough to get your shoes. Now,
thanks, buddy.
Let's get going. He'll be in his study on the ground floor of the tower. At least, I hope he's there.
Got some healing potions? There we go.
And we can be on our way.
Oh, got some battered armor. There you go, look at that. I'm starting to look cool now. Got some consumables. Oh, I drank one, shouldn't have done that. There you go. So, like you said, it's all coming back to me.
Right this way.
Oh, got a chest. Please have a mage. Because I want to be a mage. Oh, old boots. Gotta put those on. Yeah, look at that, I got boots. Yeah, it's got a very World of Warcraft aesthetic to it, which I actually like. I like this art style.
Greatest invention. The Well of Souls. Imagine an end to war. An end to death.
The Well of Souls. Sounds very Indiana Jones-esque. Cool. Let's get out of here, man. Run, run. Okay, sprint. There's no real jump in here, so only has jumps when you get to certain moments. Get going. Run, Forrest, run.
Storms. If you can find anything useful.
Oh, weapon rack. Got a kite shield. I'm gonna be a mage though, so. Put my inventory on. Armor. There we go. Now
wait.
I can block.
Do you hear something?
Nope, I do not. Can't go that way. Oh crap. Don't worry, I got him. You gotta time your blocks too in this game. To break them. One, two, and I should be able to turn. Yeah, got him. Open him up. Yeah, it's pretty cool. What does?
Oh, that longbow's bound to be useful. Move! Move!
Where do you see the longbow? Oh, right here. You see it from that far away. Cool. Secondary weapon, yep. I think, how do I switch? No. Okay, that's my radial menu. There we go, there it is.
Let's shoot them before they see us.
I love how I've got regenerating arrows. This is awesome. Pretty cool. Maybe I'll stick with this. I remember how much fun it was doing this sword board and that. Oh man, this is so awesome. Okay, where do I go here?
I bet you're still groggy, but just keep moving.
I am, dude. Chill your boots.
Move!
I am, man. This guy is kind of annoying, right? Don't you think? I think he is.
Your light mocks terror.
Man, I killed these guys pretty quick. They weren't up to challenge, and I'm playing normal. I should have probably upped the difficulty on this.
Daggers are deadly if you catch an enemy unaware. Speed more than makes up for their size.
Cool, let's see if I can do that. I forget how to crouch. Daggers. Oh, I reset the camera.
Up ahead. If you can sneak up on them with your daggers, you should be able to finish them quickly and quietly.
I think I got him. I think so. I think it's press X when I get close to them. Oh, that didn't work. Screw it. I don't need stealth. I don't need stealth. Screw that. Overrated. I'm like Legolas. Shoot. Boom. Alright, let's go. I figure I'm getting close to being out of the tutorial soon. Cool. Magic, baby. Now I got some magic. Now I'm really cool. Let's get going. Nothing there. All right. Go down here. Trying to get my way out. That's funny. Oh, man. I love how everything just pops in. Oh my god, a spider! Boss fight! Got him. Yeah, he's not much. He's not tough. Oh, stab. That's what I want. Now we're cooking with gas. Now that's what I want.
We completely covered the tunnel. Maybe you can use that staff to burn a path group north.
Of course, man.
Burn them. Burn them.
Still have my shield, so that's good. That's awesome. Burning the spiders. Oh, he's not dead yet? cool. Did I just, like, catch that dude on fire? Because that's not cool. That's why I took mana regen as a stat, because I'm gonna play this as a warlock. Nice. You gotta hold your combo down to get your powerful end attack. That's basically, I keep forgetting that I need to do that. Sweet. So it's like this tutorial, what I really like about it, it teaches a bunch of different things, right? You've got your bow and arrow, and you've got your magic. You can test out a bunch. Oh, sorry, bud.
We Praetorians are tempered in battle like the finest steel.
Nice.
We Praetorians are tempered in battle like the finest steel. This is where we part ways.
Thanks, bud. Thanks for my help, for your help, buddy.
We might have a few things to
fix. He's an inso.
Make sure you get your shoes. We can hold off the Tawafa here.
Well, 95%. I think this is where most people chose. That was the interesting thing about the choices. It used the data, basically, of why it's online. A lot of stuff's online. It chose where the community chose.
I suppose these might be able to help if the Tawafa realize what you are.
I think that's what that was. I'm not sure, though. Maybe I'm confused.
But just keep going, Pat. I'll see right, you we'll on go. The outside.
We'll get in there, man. I just wanted you to help me, that's all. But I think I'm going to have a boss fight up here soon, if I remember. It's getting like this big wave of... You can get a better view of your friend by clicking R. Alright, cool. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Let's keep going. Oh, that's my little magic potion. I like that. That's pretty cool. I gotta remember to use that. My skills. Okay, a cutscene. Oh man, fast loading. Man, it didn't load that fast back in the day. I can tell you that. Not on Xbox or PlayStation 3, because I pretty much own this game on all the consoles. This is probably going to be one of my longer playthroughs. It's just because I love this game so much, and I want to show you kind of a bit of the open world a little bit, like of the main first area. Formoros, Hoogs, Hugs.
Please forgive me. You must be terribly confused by all of this. I am Formoros Hugs, and this is my laboratory. Everything you see here is dedicated to one thing, the Well of Souls.
Yeah, so basically, is this playable 100%? This could be verified. I think the reason why is the display and probably text legibility. But yeah, they could easily get this to kind of playable, like 100% verified. I do recommend you play through this yourselves and choose the questions you want, because it's pretty cool.
We're in the Feylands, miles away from the front.
We're in the Feyland, yes, we are. Man, this world's big too. It's like pretty massive.
Yes, yes,
let's get out of here. Come on.
Fascinating.
See these cutscenes? Back in the day, these were like pre-rendered cutscenes, I guess. But I find their in-game cutscenes of the day better than that. That's just my opinion, but.
Perhaps I should go see. Sir, Mr. Hughes, the Tawafa have reached the lab.
Not the Tawafa. Oh, dude. Like, how close are they? Pretty close.
We've got to get you out of here now, quickly.
I can fight them, man. Look at the size of me. I'm huge. Look at the muscles I've got.
Find Agath. He's a friend.
I will do it, man.
No matter what else, stay alive.
For no matter what? That sounds like Last of the Mohicans. Stay alive. I will find you. Remember that waterfall scene in Last of the Mohicans? If not, check it out. Great movie. Great music, great soundtrack, but that's what he tells the girl. Well, no matter what, stay alive. I will find you. Oh my gosh, I'm getting like destroyed here. Let's go, come on, let's get out of here. Work our way up. I am running. Such an epic kind of cinematic opening to this game. It's so really cool. Like, I kind of wish they make a sequel to this. Nice. I love my magic. Okay, I gotta keep going this way, I think. Yeah. Oh, wrong way. The camera moves so fast. I do apologize. I've got it. Like, this is one of my issues. One of the only issues I had with the game back in the day was... Gonna heal up. Boss fight. Yeah, I remember this back in the day. I'm like, oh my god. I remember dying to this guy back in the day. I think I did. I think I get to use my reckoning skills too in this guy. Like, you get a special mechanic. Gonna dive it away. Gotta get out of this guy's way. Oh, he got me. Oh, he got me, right? Man, this is... Oh, man, I gotta stop trying to get my third hit in hand. Did he just smack me in the face? Come on, hit him. Come on, you got him, Pete. There you go. Reckoning skills. Remember back in the day when you had these quick time events? Oh, that was awesome. That was pretty fun. Oh, cool. I got some pile of loot. Let me go in and put on an accessory, which is a ring. There you go. Cool. Let's get out of here. Open the doors and get out of here. We killed that bad guy. Now we should be in a lush green forest. Yeah. There we go. Oh, I leveled up. Cool. All right. So this is the skill tree. So I don't want to do stealth. I'm going to do spellcraft. Okay, so this is slight range, PC well on stealth. Okay. You can create powerful gems using lament quality shards. Better quality shard drops more frequently. Okay, cool. That's pretty cool. Persuasion for crime rate. No, I don't want that. Mercantile. Lockpick. Oh, yeah, this is kind of... I do want lockpick. All right, there's my thing. I don't want to do might. Finesse, sorcery, that's where I want to go. Alright, so weapon attack, unlocks charge special attacks for staff and chakras. Long hours of study practice enables you to wield scepters very efficiently. You've learned to channel incredible amounts of energy through your staff. Yeah, so I'm going to go right here. And there we go. Okay, you can go down to inventory, armor. Yeah, rusty leggings, there we go. And you get heavier too, you can't take a lot of stuff with you. Sagecraft pouch, oh cool. All right, so this is kind of the start of the open world map. Let me see if I can get the map. So this is the map, this is the world map. It is pretty big. Like, it's pretty big, and there's expansion areas, too. Like, it's pretty big area. Man, there's, like, so much to be done in this game. Like, so much to be done. It is so... Like, each of these are sub-areas, right? Like, you can go down to your local map, which I'm in right now, and it's, like, it's pretty big. so. I wish I could change the display to make it widescreen.
I saw your fight in there. Can they really have a troll?
Yep.
I don't know how the Twother found us, but if their fate was kind to collapse that doorway behind you, they would have chased us into the glade. Hughes ran off, you say?
Alright, let's go find him.
Good luck out there.
Thanks, man. So there's, like, you're basically now, it's like a fog of war. And that's my quest I'm in right now. So you can go down into your quest log. So you have Into the Light, the main quest, and your faction side task. There's so much stuff in here to do. And it all shows up on the map, so. And there's crafting stuff you can get. Regents to craft. Alright, cool. Yeah, there's so much to do here. And there's tons of DLC in this game. Like, I'm actually going to redo it as a mage. I've never played this game as a mage, and I really want to... Oh, anything up here, I wonder? There's all kinds of stuff you can do. Like, there's stuff to discover in the world. Again, it's not... Like, it's not as big as Skyrim, that's what I was gonna say, but, like, there's so much you can do here. Oh, look at that, buckler, some powder. So you want to explore, like, there's a random cave up here, like, a random dungeon. Like, you can just go and have fun. When you go into a mine, it's like, you like, there's so much here to be, like, just explore. I'm sure there's quests here back in the first little town, but just the fact that you can go in, just like in, you know, it's like almost like Skyrim light in a lot of ways, but you know, there's treasure in here. Oh, and I got killed by a trap. Oh, lock picking. Oh yeah, this one you gotta be. Oh, you gotta. Okay. Okay, I'm doing. My picking was not good here, so. Force, you get a 10% chance, which. Oh, I didn't even need to move my pick. Sometimes you have to move it, so yeah, it's like, you know, cool stuff in here. But anyway, I'll exit and get out of here, because I think I gotta come back here for some quests anyway, but. The fact is that there's so much of this game. Kind of wish it took advantage of the full screen. Look at that, touchscreen. So you can do it, like, that's the, so you, look how many skills I can add, possibly. Let's get out of here. Loading's really fast. And they don't respawn, which, hey, I'm a really big fan of in a lot of games. But, like, I can remember playing this back in the day where I'd spend time just, you know, running around the world and getting into trouble. Who's this dude? Oh, yeah, this guy. Yeah, I remember him. He's been waiting for me, apparently, I think.
You've come from the tower, haven't you? Name's Agarth.
Agarth, yeah.
Maybe you could help an old fate weaver.
Oh, this is where you learn about your fates, yeah, and your cards and stuff. Oh my god, I forgot about that part of the game.
He's probably dead by now. When he started his experiments here, he asked me if they'd ever be successful. The cards told me that the Well of Souls would work. The old man took it pretty well.
I'm so happy that I've already finished the game. I'm going to try to get the new expansion to finish that. That came out last year, I believe. I think it came out last year.
I could spare a little help. Memory of Hughes.
And but now I can just explore and do, because I don't think I finished all the side quests.
You're the one.
So now it's a good opportunity to just play through and relax, because I've done all the main story. Still do the main story, but see what it's like from the perspective of a mage, because like I said, I think it'll be harder for me to be honest with you. Oh, I love the being able to, like, I think I should be able to scroll in on the field of view, too. When your fate mirror is full, the fate symbol will pulse. You can use your fate energy to enter reckoning mode. Yeah, there it is. How do I get into reckoning mode? There it is, yep. Here we go. Wrecking, baby. It's a kind of a gimmicky thing, but... And then you go into this and do your little cutscene. And the harder you do it, you get more XP if you can max out the Y button. That's a pretty cool little take on it, really. You get a little bit more XP. Which is pretty cool.
What? How?
How'd I do it? Yeah, I remember. He freaks out that...
How the world was supposed to work. You just... Fate is the will of the god.
Not for me, buddy.
I'm going to do a reading.
Oh, yeah, he's going to read my fate.
I'll tell you if I see your death.
Do you always see
it's
death?
A gift. Some people paint landscapes. Other people write poetry.
I see death.
I peered into the weave of fate's tapestry and
that's
see
awesome.
People's deaths.
He's so nonchalant, but...
That would be my guess. He was an academic, but he had a proper respect.
Show me my fate.
I'll be seeing your place in the pattern of death, or at least I should be. You're real, right?
You can't see my fate?
Fate's weave is always hard to see. It's in motion.
You're real, right? No, I should have said no, I'm the ghost.
This is true. And I'm not saying I believe it.
The voice acting is tremendous in this game, too. Alright, so... Newly resurrect, your fate is blank. Or you can choose what you want. As an acolyte, you're devoted to the arcana mastery of elemental forces. You prefer to destroy your opponents with raw magic. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that. So you can choose which way you want to do it, but I'm going to go to acolyte, tier 1.
To determine. It could mean nothing.
I could have said you're terrible at it, but...
I've never had a reason to doubt my own readings, but we should consult with Arden. I'll meet you at his home to the east.
Okay, we'll do.
I'm going to see if I can be of any help to the bats, trust it. I don't know if you've got one.
He lives in he's really horrible at his job.
I'll meet you. What this
all right, so I chose to be an acolyte, which is awesome. And we keep moving. Okay.
Still here, huh? Can't quite decide what this
all right, cool. Let's go. But you can see this game is, like, pretty fun and compelling, and there's so much you can do in this game. Like, I absolutely love it. I know, and I think it reviewed extremely well back in the day. Like, I think it got review of like 80 on average. It scored Lorestone. Oh yeah, that's cool. I forgot about all these little kind of world building stuff and meta game and. Music's amazing too. Big Huge Games did a great job with this. So, like, you can see, like, the world is massive. And again, this is just one, this is just Carolyn. There's all different areas within it, right? So. Oh, this is a town? You discovered a new location. You can fast travel. Sweet. You can fast travel this location now. The mine, so it's pretty cool. So anyway, yeah, I'm gonna have some fun with this. I'll probably do follow-up videos on this and go into my abilities. I just wanted to make sure I didn't have any ability queue. Oh, what's this guy? Okay, that's my ability tree over here, so yeah.
Watch out.
Nothing to see back here. Just a man working for his pay. We in Gorehart like to stay focused on our...
I don't care what you race. It's a tragedy whenever anyone's savage like this. Just look at the poor creature. She's been beaten to the brink of death. It appears she was attacked with some manner of short blade. Likely a dagger.
Oh, she was poisoned.
He stood by as she called. I don't know whether we possess the knowledge to treat such a wound.
So I gotta go in on a quest. So yeah, I'd like to help, right?
Only one. I'm going to
you can be really a bad guy in this too.
I would do it, but she spends her days in the precipice overlooking the village. She doesn't think we're open by now.
Cool, and there's tons of stuff in here. Like, you've got your stash and things like that. Some DLC stuff. Should have some DLC stuff, I think. Oh, no special deliveries in there. But if you bought DLC, it would be in there. Stuff like that. So quest markers. It's really cool. Anyway, we'll call it there. very playable on it. I do highly recommend this game. I can't recommend this game enough if you're into these type of adventure RPG, quasi-open world games that have tons of DLC, great dialogue, great story, side missions. I mean, you can invest hundreds of hours in this game. Once again, very playable. I am Pete. Thanks so much for checking out the channel, watching these videos. Can you be quiet so I can finish my ending, please? Have an awesome day. Please consider subscribing, liking, and getting in the comments. Bye.